I want to share an intriguing Pew Research Center study that aligns with the themes of this channel as Black SDA history. We've talked a lot about the Black past, Black history, and how a belief in the apocalypse or the eschaton, and particularly the second coming of Jesus, second advent, parousia, has been a mainstay of Black thought from the first Blacks who were here in the, well, in this iteration, at least, in what is now the United States, throughout our enslavement, Reconstruction, post-Reconstruction, Jim and Jane Crow, on into the Civil Rights era, to the present. A belief in the second coming of Jesus has bolstered, provided a psychological and mental catharsis and I would say comfort. It's given us a sense of justice and fairness in times in which we could not, in which Blacks could not appeal to the American political system, the justice system, the authorities, as it were, times in which we had no other recourse. A belief in the second coming provided a sense of meaning, fairness, hope, resilience, escape, all of those, and more. And it turns out that this Pew Research Center study has revealed that Blacks, and this is specifically African Americans, are still a people of the eschaton. There is still a strong belief in the end of the world and the second coming of Jesus. There has been a lot about the secularization of America, and it's a lot of these studies is unclear if Black people are supposed to be included in these secularization studies and statements. But this seems to indicate that, whatever the case, if definitely Americans are, but if Blacks are becoming more secular, that is, without a Christian worldview or orientation, they have retained a belief in the eschaton. So let's look at this, and you can find this, just Google Pew Research End Times. And of course, Pew is the leading poll organization in the United States. And I think for the most part, the studies are dependable and accurate, although we will discuss that. So the name of the article is about 4 in 10 U.S. adults believe humanity is living in the end times, living in the end times. Now, this is very interesting. Whenever I fasten on a Pew Research poll, I think the last one we've commented on this channel was a 2015 poll that states that Seventh-day Adventism is the most diverse religion in the United States, the most ethnically and racially diverse religion, church in the United States. You want to pay attention to how the poll was done, who they polled, how many they polled, was it representative, what questions were asked, all of that, especially when it's something that that you think is important and you want to draw some conclusions from. So this is part of a wider study. The poll was conducted from April 11 to 17, 2022. And of course, that date is important because it's still roughly in the COVID period. The quarantine started in March 2020. And yes, it was sort of ebbing during this time, but there is still the effluvium and residue of that COVID period and a lot of mass anxiety and gloom and doom as to what's coming. I think now when you say that it's the end times, no one really raises an eyebrow anymore. Now, there are all sorts of studies about secular apocalypse. That's what it's called in the subfield, the field of apocalyptic and eschatological studies, a secular apocalypse. You see a lot of this in movies. But the end times, whether it comes from climate or weapons or war or an epidemic, is not so far-fetched, it doesn't seem like. All right, although as usual, it seems like if you said, you know, the end times are near to 10 people in a room, there will be 10 different notions of what exactly is meant by the end times and what will catalyze the end. But anyhow, so this is April 11 to 17, 2022, and 10,156 U.S. adults were polled. And when you look at the demographics of the poll, they do reflect the U.S. demographics, which I think is about maybe 60, 65% white people, 15, 16% Hispanic, Latino, Latina, 14% Black, 5% Asian. I think it roughly goes along with the national demographics. Now, this is and the article links to this. This is the original study from which the questions on the end times were culled. So this article was a part of this study. And it's interesting because they segued, the questioners at Pew segued into the end times from questions about climate change. And that's a very interesting segue. You hear Christians more than ever when you're looking at Matthew 24, Mark 21, Luke 13, Jesus's response to the disciples' query, when will you come? And Jesus speaks about pestilences and desolation and nations angry at each other and wars and rumors of wars and the sea and the waves roaring and a fearful looking of the things that are coming. I think nowadays the de rigueur interpretation of that text is that's climate change. You know, if there's hunger, it's because of the, of course, there are always human political mechanisms, but it's because of something climate related. If the sea and the waves are roaring, that is the oceans and flooding. If there's pestilence, it's something having to do with climate. If nations are warring, it's because of a scarcity of resources, because of overmining and overworking. There's now a climate interpretation of that you didn't see. I don't think you even saw 30 years ago, 30, 40 years ago. So this is interesting that the Pew pollers chose to segue from climate in this way. So it's how religion intersects with Americans' views of the environment. And these are the questions. These are the questions. And particularly for our purposes with the end times It starts on page 9 of this study. And like I said, all the links are here. So do you believe we are living in the end times? That's the question. Do you believe we are living in the end times? And like I said, there was rather a, maybe not precipitous, but it's interesting how the questions sort of curved this way. Okay, and you can read the questions in your own time. Do you believe Jesus will return to the earth someday? Do you believe Jesus will return to the earth someday? So we go from end times and then, well, how exactly is the world going to end? And that is Jesus returning. That's the most popular scheme. Do you believe Jesus will return to earth in your lifetime? In your lifetime. All right, so these are very interesting questions, and that's the end of that. So there were about four, I believe there's just four questions about the end times. Do you believe we're living the end times? Do you believe Jesus will return to earth someday? Do you believe Jesus will return to earth in your lifetime? Which of the following statements comes closest to your view of Jesus' return, even if none is exactly right? All right, so these are the results. So this is the U.S. Protestants and evangelical and historically Black traditions, especially likely to believe humanity is living in the end times. So when they polled these Americans, remember there was over 10,000 demographically representative Americans polled. And I believe that only Protestants were polled. So these are Protestants in evangelical churches. The term evangelical is ambiguous and vague. I think certain denominations we know without a doubt are evangelical, but others we question, are they evangelical? Of course, Seventh-day Adventists. We may say there was a time when we said we aren't evangelical. That was, you know, we're blatantly not evangelical because we're different. But now I'm not sure what the average quote unquote Adventist would say if we are evangelical. Obviously, Adventists believe in the fundamental beliefs that our raison d'etre is to share the gospel with the entire world, the Evangelion, the good news found in Revelation 14, 6 through 12. And that is, of course, fundamentally evangelical because it's gospel-centered to proselytize everyone in the world with the gospel. That is, that's evangelical to the core. But of course, that word, I would say, that term, especially from the 1950s, 60s, 70s, 80s, 90s on, especially with the religious right and religious fundamentalism and conservatism, has some baggage with it that we don't always assume or think applies to us. Okay, so, but that's neither here nor there. That was a long digression, but it's neither here nor there. Because what we're interested in is, where is it going to take me here? Okay, that's just the, okay, this is a larger graph, so we can just look at this. Okay, so all U.S. adults, first it gives us for all U.S. adults, and remember, these are the questions that we looked at in the PDF earlier. Do you believe we're living in the end times? So about 40% say yes, and about 60% say no. Okay, 39% yes, 58% no. And then it breaks down the Christians. Once again, this can be a little bit confusing because the, you know, it, initially it told us that it was going to look at Protestant and evangelical. So you may have a hard time distinguishing what's what here, but what I want to draw your attention to is historically Black, and it is a much higher percentage than course, all U.S. adults, because all of those wouldn't be Christian or identify as Christian, but it's significantly higher than Christians in the U.S. writ large. So 76% of Blacks believe that we are living in the end times. 70% of Blacks in historically Black Protestant denominations. And I would say, I can't find where Pew specifies what those are, but I would say definitely Methodist, Baptist, Kojic, Church of God in Christ, Pentecostal. I would say probably those denominations. Okay. So you can see it's inordinately high. And I don't, you know, that with my introduction, I think that that's very accurate. It's very accurate, but it's something just to see it and have it done here with such a reputable source. And I think a solid study. Okay. Now it goes to down here. This is more all U.S. adults. All right. So once again, you kind of see this may reinforce some stereotypes. I think there is a belief that Republicans are more conservative or evangelical Christians. There's a greater number of part of those denominations, and that may be backed up by actual studies. So they are higher. When it says, do you believe that we are living in the end times? 45% of Republicans say yes, while only 33% of Democrats say yes. And then another stereotype is that, well, you're more likely to believe this and maybe even be a thoroughgoing Christian, an evangelical Christian, if you're less educated. That's another stereotype that has persisted, I think. So high school or less, 49%. Some college, 40%. College graduate, 27%. So it kind of goes down. It kind of goes down with the more education someone has. Once again, I don't buy that, but it seems like, I don't buy the notion that just because you're educated, you're less likely to believe in the some sort of apocalypse or end times. But this study seems to bear that out. Okay, so this is all U.S. adults down here. Do you believe we are living in the end times? 34% of whites, 68% of Blacks say yes, 41% Hispanic, and 33% Asian. So as it says, we have some explaining to do, because Blacks are higher than 27% higher than the nearest group to them, and that is Hispanics, at 41%, and they are exactly double the whites who say yes, we are living in the end times. And so, I would immediately want to excavate why this is the case, and I think that we'll do that in another video. Hopefully, this will have the other graph. Okay, a slight majority of Americans believe Jesus will return to earth one day. Okay, so do you believe Jesus will return to earth someday? All U.S. adults, 55% say yes. Very interesting stat. 25% say no, and then 16% say I don't believe in Jesus. So this is no, but it's sort of like a tricky kind of thing. So no, because I don't believe in Jesus, but this is a different group. Okay. So once again, with historically Black, we have 86%, compared to 75% of Christians overall. So Blacks are a part of that, but obviously they would be a smaller part of it. Okay, once again, we have this is roughly proportionate to the question, are we living in the end times? 69% of Republicans say that, yes, Jesus will return to earth someday. 45% Democrats. We see the responses along the lines, although these are a little, these are discrepant with the earlier figures. I wonder why the difference is, because you can see it's slightly higher here. Once again, Pew is not always clear if this is all U.S. adults down here, or if this is if these are the Christians here. So that would be interesting to know. But I mean, I assume that it goes from Christians up here, let's say historically Black Protestant Christians, okay, and then all Blacks here. So I think that it makes sense that all Blacks would be lower than just than Black Christians, okay? So still, though, we see that Blacks are far higher in number, believing that Jesus will return to earth one day, than any other group. 53% of whites, 55% Hispanic, 39% Asian, and 77% Blacks. All right. Finally, this is the final question, although there was one more, but do you believe that Jesus will return to earth someday? Do you believe Jesus will return to earth someday? And this is, do not believe Jesus will return to earth. So this is someday, and then this goes into in your lifetime. Okay, so this is a little bit more of a complex graph. But once again, Blacks have looks like roughly the highest numbers. Well, in the first one, yes, Jesus will definitely probably return in their lifetime. You may kind of wonder definitely and then probably, but you can see how that would be the same question. Not sure if Jesus will return within lifetime. So here Blacks are more aligned with other Christians, it seems like. No, Jesus will definitely probably not return in their lifetime. So, but Blacks are a little lower here. Okay, and do not believe Jesus will return to earth in their lifetime, 11%. So once again, you see Blacks are still leading, if you will, in believing in Jesus's return. And once again, this bears this out as well. But we're not looking for the highest. Remember that, because some of the questions, you know, aren't. So yeah, those are the results. Let's go back to our main article. This is where we were. And this is our main article. So you can read more about the breakdown here. This is just what we just went over, but just the great majority, 86%. Do you believe Jesus will return to earth someday? 86% of Blacks in Protestant Christian denominations say yes. Yes. And then Blacks in general, 77% say yes, and this is far and above any other ethnic group. So this is interesting to think about. Once again, I think that I will do a video on why this is the case, although really most videos on this channel treat on this in one way or another, but I think this is worth a dedicated video. But Black people are still people of the eschaton. And there is, as the study bears out, a strong belief that we are living in the end times and that Jesus will return soon. So in one way, you can say that most Blacks in America are Adventists with a lower A.